Hi, Yasin.
Hi, Hiroshi.
Yeah, how are you?
I am very well, thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, Sudan is far away from Tokyo, so I'm so delighted.
I am delighted to talk to you in Japan.
Well, for Sudan people, Japan might be quite far away. And then, what is the kind of image of Japan for you in general in Sudan?
The image of Japan is a very positive image.
I see.
It's a country which
Thank you.
made itself from after the war and became a big economic power.
Okay. Thank you very much. Well, you know, just frankly, you know, I have one question because, you know, Sudan went through a lot of political chaos, and now it
That's
is now time of the rebuilding the country.
Yes, that's right.
And there are two challenges. One, which is, of course, rebuilding is really tough. Second, coronavirus. So,
That's right,
yeah,
yes.
okay. First of all, how corona, you know, COVID-19 is going on over there in Sudan?
Coronavirus infection in Sudan is happening, and people and the government are taking strict measures to limit the spread of the infection. For example, they closed all the cities. All the cities are closed, and people, even here in Khartoum, the capital, we have three bridges, and they close the bridges. So you stay where you are, and you have to wear masks. You have to clean your hands with soap and water. There are a lot of program on TV for people how to express social distancing. But the coronavirus has affected Sudan badly from the economic point of view.
Yeah, I believe so. Particularly, how about the mosque activity? People can gather the mosque now?
Yes, people can go to the shop and buy their things, but the main problem is still the hospital are closed, only taking coronavirus cases, or only taking people come to the emergency department. So people are still suffering from that side.
Your country experienced a serious coup, you know, 2 years ago, and also after that, there are a lot of turbulence, then going up, now taking off from the problem area to the kind of going building the country. And you said that the economical impact is really serious because of corona. I hope, you know, this taking off and the corona's economic impact cannot, how can I say, cause a serious problem.
Yes, in fact, in December 2019, last year, there was a big revolution, a civilian revolution, peaceful revolution against the previous regime, which was riddled with corruption, lack of democracy. And now the new government, the revolution government, in partnership with the army, they're trying to build the economy again. But the Sudan, I don't know if you heard, last month there was an international conference. It's called Partnered with Sudan, and Japan joined in that conference to help Sudan with the economic development. For example, canceling the loans and giving aid, technical or financial. So Japan was part of that conference, sponsored by the European Union and led by Germany.
I understand. Particularly in a revolution time, a lot of casualties.
Yes, there was during the revolution, the protest, unfortunately, many young people, as many as 200 people, lost their lives. But now there is peace, and people can express their demands in a peaceful way without being shot by the police or by the secret services.
Without the secret service, that's good. So now, because of that revolution happened, you are now working really easier.
It's safe. Yeah, now it's safe. It's safe. And some of the foreign people and embassies who left, they start coming back. But because of the corona, the airport is still closed. So from yesterday, they trying to open the airport and the border so people who are outside, they can come back.
How about future, you know, I mean, like what the current Sudan government and the Sudan people, you know, I mean, expecting a future, like what kind of industry do you want to develop in your country?
Yes, I think Sudan is a very rich country and it has many natural resources. The fairest natural resource is agriculture. It has almost 1 million square miles and very rich land to cultivate and grow crops because we have a lot of water. We have two Niles, three Niles. We have heavy rain during the during the autumn. And then now we also have mineral resources. We have oil, and we have gold, and we have other minerals.
That's good.
As well as we have a very rich animal resources. We export camels, cows, and sheep to Arab countries and Egypt for meat.
That's good. So which is a really like a treasure of the Niles.
That's right.
I hope that once corona is over, you know, of course, you know, we all need to work together to develop your country safely, right?
We hope so. We hope so. We are looking forward to rich companies like Japan to participate in the development of Sudan.
How about from your professional point of view, you are a psychiatrist. I believe that in a tough time and like such kind of revolution, a lot of people's minds are so damaged. And also, not only that Sudan itself, but South Sudan after the independence, there are a lot of tension between two countries. And so there are a lot of kind of a psychological issue, oppressions and everything happens. And from the professional view, are you contributing for that kind of a problem?
That's a very good question, Hiroshi. You know, there used to be war between South and North Sudan, and a lot of people lost their lives. A lot of people lost their homes. So people develop what we call the post-traumatic stress disorder.
You are right.
Which is from the stress of being taken out of your home, or the stress of being afraid to be killed, or I'm afraid of not having enough food. And so people suffer condition like anxiety, like depression, like stress. And from our point of view as a profession, we have made several initiatives to help these people. We have campaign to give these people psychological support. Where we trained what we call community workers. We trained the local people to help these people, to tell them about how to deal with anxiety, how to deal with depression, how to become a strong community together, and how to rebuild their lives again.
Yeah, particularly in the general public, it is really still tough to identify whether this is a real disease or a mental disease based on that.
Yes.
And your country needs such like you, such a professional. need to analyze.
Yes. Yes, that's right. We are doing a study. We have, for example, one of the famous universities here in Khartoum. It's called Ahfad University. They have a center. It's called the Trauma Center.
I see.
And this center study the effect of the war and displacement on these people.
What is a typical case which you can say right now? Are there any typical case of the victims?
Yes, there are typical cases. Typical cases like people who they become afraid to go out, people who develop symptoms, they cannot sleep well, they have fear, they have dreams and nightmares, they have no confidence in their abilities, and they're afraid from the future. So what we do in counseling, we're trying to give them hope that the future will be better. Some people who have depression or anxiety, sometimes we need to give them medication to help them sleep and to help them with the depression.
I believe that it is a tough job for you to educate people that this is a kind of a syndrome of the psychological problems. No.
Yes, it's a it's a psychological trauma. We also, in addition to talking to these people live, we do program. For example, myself, I do program on national TV and radio to talk about different things like post-traumatic stress disorder, like depression, like anxiety, like violence, like child abuse, like domestic violence against women. Like all these conditions we talk about in TV, and we try to help people how to help themselves.
Yeah, you're saying your job is quite important. You know,
yes. We have a program called JICA, which is from Japan, which helping us, the Ministry of Health, to deal with these psychological traumas.
I understand. Whatever I can do is just I want to tell this kind of story to as many people as possible to
please,
work together.
Please do.
Okay.
Please do.
Yeah. Thank you so much for today's cooperation. That I hope that we can see you soon. And and please stay healthy also.
Thank you very much, Hiroshi, for this interview, and I look forward to talking to you again.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
いかがでしたでしょうか。あのね、スーダンで、活躍している、なんていうのかな、心理学者の方なんですね、ヤセンさん。でね、彼はね、なんだろう、スーダン自体ね、実は日本から遠い国じゃないですか。ただね、忘れてはならない、すごいね、ことがありますね。つまりどういうことかと言ったら、スーダンって日本から遠い国なんですけどもね、日本もね、70年以上前にね、戦争を経験してるじゃないですか。あれと同じぐらいのね、厳しいね、戦争と革命を経験して、それがついね、去年終わってるんですよね。そして国を今なんとか立て直そうって時に、コロナになっちゃった。ということでね、経済的にもすごいダメージ。これ二重苦ですよね。で、そういう中で、彼は心理学者としてね、精神的なケア、つまりね、そういうことで苦しんでる人たちの精神的なケアをやるんですけれど、実はね、戦争とかそういうところがありま、ことがありますとね、当然のことだけども、その経験がね、心の傷になって夜中にいきなり起き出してわめいちゃったり、もう何にもやる気がなくなったりね、それからこう、精神的に不安定になってドメスティックバイオレンスになったりと、いろんなことが起きるわけです。だけど、社会ってそういうことはね、早く忘れ去りたいから、当然社会は冷たいじゃないですか。で、もう一つは病気であるということと精神的な病であるということの区別もつかないですよね。だからやっぱりそういう中でね、彼はイギリスで教育を受けた、人なんですけどね。そのイギリスで教育を受けた最先端の、心理学を持って、この難しい状況にね、挑むっていうのは大変なことかなと思います。そういう意味でね、今日は紹介したんですよ。で、これは今世界で起きてるね、21世紀のこれからの問題の一つでもあるなということです。スーダンはね、ナイル川がこう二つ、青と白ナイル、この二つのナイル川が一緒になって、そして大きなナイル川になってこう、 地中海に注ぐ、そのちょうど接点のところにある、ハルツームという町のね、首都な、が首都で、彼はそこで仕事してるんですけどね。彼言ってました。その、まあ、肥沃な土地とね、豊かな穀物と、それから、人材もあるし、それから、まあ、家畜、動物ね、いろんなもの、それからリソース、そういうものがいろいろあるんですよ。だから、この豊かなね、土地をね、本当に取り戻してほしいなと。そういう苦労をね、通り越して、取り戻してほしいなと。そういうふうに思いました。ぜひね、日本では経験のないことですけど、世界の課題ってこういうことなんだなってことを理解するためにもね、まあ、何度か聞いてみていただければなと思います。